6, 4, 3, 2, 1, and liftoff.
For the first time in my life, I saw the horizon as a curved line. It was accentuated by a thin seam of dark blue light, the atmosphere. This was not the ocean of air I had been told it was. I was terrified by its fragile appearance. In 1983, German astronaut Ulf Merbold, on board NASA's space shuttle, was struck by how vulnerable the layer that protects us from outer space really was. He was right. Industrialization and economic growth have given us many commodities and technologies, but they have also generated a dangerous side effect: pollution.
Air pollution has a great impact on human health.
More than 7 million people die per year due to the effects of air quality.
It's a big problem. Populations are growing, and the impacts on health are an economic cost that I think governments are very interested in.
Understanding how we are affecting our atmosphere and the quality of the air we breathe is essential not just to continue developing our societies, but also to our health, and therefore our survival. By combining measurements from satellites, ground stations, and aircraft over the South Korean peninsula, KORUS-AQ will create the most complete picture of air quality ever measured.
As atmospheric chemists, we do know a lot about the basics of air quality, but the specifics of what happens in Korea are not something that we know a lot about.
It's not a mystery to us that there's a lot of air pollution. What we're really trying to do is learn how we can best help the South Koreans improve their air quality.
The government is trying to come up with a better strategy to fix this issue, but it's not that easy. You know, it's very complicated scientific issues we are facing. So I think this mission really helped us to understand what is going on our country.
But air pollution is also an environmental problem common to other cities in many countries.
It turns out that there's many cities around the world that have similar problems to Seoul, even in the United States. And so this field study will help improve the models and the processes in the models that will benefit many other cities around the world.
The information gathered throughout the KORUS-AQ campaign will help us improve our models of air quality and better understand the flow and interaction of pollutants in our atmosphere.
Almost anyone who you tell about the KORUS-AQ experiment will immediately ask about how much of it's coming from China. Transboundary pollution is always a concern, and we came here to look at that as well. But we've had the good fortune of having a weather condition that has created a lot of stagnation in the Korean country and has prevented Chinese emissions from having a large impact on Korea.
Yeah, we sort of expected that frequently there would be pollution from China blowing over Korea. But due to the meteorological conditions this year, that didn't seem to happen very much.
And it turns out on some days, the emissions from China is impacting South Korea, but on many days that we're here, it's entirely due to the pollution emitted by the 51 million people living in South Korea.
And what we believe is that this will motivate the Koreans to understand that they can make a difference in their own air quality by making local changes of things that they can control rather than worrying only about what's coming from outside.
Having detailed information on the sources causing air pollution is one of the most important outcomes of an air quality study. Decisions can be made in order to address environmental issues on a region.
We have also seen that the position of some emission sources, in particular with Seoul being in the northwest corner of the country, and also many of the power plants and chemical facilities upwind of the city, that the location of some sources is potentially creating a bigger problem in Seoul than is necessary. So looking at the balance of where activities are located in Korea is likely going to be a topic of interest for the outcomes from KORUS.
Real-time measurements of emissions over the Korean Peninsula has already proven the importance of this field study. Further, and more detailed analysis of the data collected during the campaign will help scientists improve air quality models.
So now we will have the 6 weeks of data of hundreds of different compounds to evaluate our models with to see how they do during these 6 weeks. And then if we can make our models reproduce this period, reproduce all the observations we've made, then we can have confidence that it will work well next year or next fall.
These models also help us test how we can best reduce the air pollution by, what if we cleaned up the cars, how much would that help? What if we cleaned up the power plants, how much would that lower air pollution? So these models are useful tools to look at different scenarios.
It's relatively simple to filter out or scrub emissions, but it's not inexpensive. So if you know which ones will have the largest impact, then you can target those and still have good economic productivity and protect your population.
Computer models can help assess air pollution problems and guide politicians in the decision-making process to lessen industrial impacts on the environment.
We definitely have technologies that will help us with air quality, but the economic factors always come into play. And so people are always looking for ways to do things more economically, but that doesn't always mean doing them cleanly. And so regulations are needed to make sure that we don't take shortcuts and that we make the proper investments in making sure that our activities are not having an undue impact on the environment.
After weeks of hard work and intense data collection, the KORUS-AQ field study has enhanced our knowledge of our planet. Our understanding of the complex processes that take place in our atmosphere.
With KORUS-AQ, we take another step toward the future of an air quality observing system that is going to make us able to be more effective in identifying where poor air quality is developing and how to better understand what's driving it.
What we've learned here can also be applied to other cities and hopefully can help us improve air quality around the world.
Because I think the air pollution issues is not only for us, but also for some other countries.
We are paving the way to better understand pollution and our impact on air quality in our atmosphere. But there's still much work to do ahead of us.
Well, I think that as we reach 7 billion people on this planet, the consequences of what we do have a very significant impact on the environment, and we need to understand what we're doing very well.
So this is the first step of a long journey. We will still need additional aircraft measurements and ground-based measurements going forward.
We can't be everywhere with the plane, but now that we demonstrate here how the plane works in concert with satellite observations in the ground, we can use satellite observations to point the aircraft to the places where we can learn the most or the places that are in most need of understanding what's going on.
So we must continue investigating, exploring this world to improve the lives of all of us who call this planet home.